In order to understand the necessity of neuromuscular re-education, as well as assess potential muscular conditions, I would like to refer you to these pictures. On the first picture, we can see muscles in the normal resting tone. The physical manifestation of the normal resting tone are the absence of discomfort, tension or restriction of motion, and the absence of having urge to massage this particular muscle. On the second picture, we can see a muscle with a high resting tone. As you can see, the same muscle is shortened and widened. In this case, the person can experience a little discomfort. At the same time, we can expect that the muscle will demonstrate some degree of insufficiency during stabilization and movement action. This high resting tone of muscle can result from physical and/or emotional overload. Irritation of spinal nerves can also initiate the reflectoric higher tone. This insignificant higher muscle tone has to be addressed. Otherwise, muscles will gradually accumulate tension to the point that microcirculation will be disturbed and paralyzing system will be activated. Consequently, the person will start experiencing pain and limitation of range of motion, along with many more dysfunctional attributes. In such case, we can say that this particular muscle will demonstrate insufficiency in movement and stabilization of region, which in turn will contribute significantly to the instability of the joint. Additionally to the functional insufficiency that these muscles would sustain, if this painful stage of muscular abnormalities would not be timely addressed, the muscle could develop a hypertone condition with the pathological changes within the muscles. Usually, the higher resting tone of muscles should be addressed by receiving massage or by constant warm-up routine. In picture number 3, we can see difficult muscular pathology. As we know, muscle mass is composed by muscular fibers. In this case, partial fibers of the same muscles accumulate much more tension than other part of the same muscle, which make this part of the muscle shorter than the rest of the fibers of the same muscle. Any attempt that will cause muscle to participate in movement or stabilization will also cause the overtense part of muscles to be disproportionately overworked. In this case, massage alone or regular stretching will not help. If this difficult pathology will not be adequately addressed, it is very possible that a person will suffer a significant muscular tear. As a matter of fact, the constant overwork of this part of the muscle will lead little by little to the partial microscopic muscle fiber tears, to the point that one day the most insignificant movement can cause a massive partial or complete tear. In this condition, not only will stretching not be helpful, but to some degree it can aggravate the abnormality. At the time of maximum stretching, Golgi organ that located in the tendon fires electrical impulse that cause muscular relaxation. With this pathological change in the muscle, this impulse will bring relaxation to an unstressed part of the muscles and will not affect the pathological changed part. The cure will come in the form of the post-isometric relaxation techniques. In order to explain what the post-isometric relaxation techniques are, we first have to discuss types of muscular actions. The muscular actions are divided in several types: isotonic, isometric, and other actions. Isotonic action is such when muscles contract with no extra load, gradually shortening and transmitting the power to sustain the movement. Isometric action is such when muscles attempt to contract, but because it's countered with the equal force in opposite direction, it cannot produce any movement. As a result, the whole muscle mass is forced to stretch in order to fight this resistance.
when we perform post-endometrial relaxation to determine the maximum range of motion. Even if it's limited, we have to see the maximum. And let's say here, this is the maximum range of motion, and we will a little bit to 30-35 degrees, we'll move the, we'll open the angle to 35 degrees, and we will ask gradually our client to push against our hands. Gradually push, push more, and when we reach the point that we feel that is pretty strong, or for us difficult even to resist, we will ask him to stay like this, and after 30 seconds approximately of isometric tension, we will ask him to relax, not to push. To relax, not to push, totally relax, and after this, with inhale and exhale, like blowing at a candle, totally relaxing, we will have to be isometric tension, no isotonic, no dynamic movement. We hold like this, 30 seconds. And relax. Totally relax. We will ask him from this position. The other approach to do isometric tension, if your client physically stronger than you in the lat, you can use bed sheets and in like this form, you putting him in a position that his maximum flexion normal and like 30 degree less, you staying, you controlling totally situation. You're putting like this, your hands, and you ask him to push against. Push, 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 more, and external rotation movement. Now, in this case, we just will ask our client to relax totally, and we will try how much free of pain. If there is some pain, now, if I move, for example, to a certain point and he feel pain, I will move a little bit, 30 degree, and I will put his thigh against my chest, and here is two choices. I can from here to hold, or just from here. And I will ask him to push against my chest like this direction. Yeah, like this. You see, there is tension already created. Inhale and exhale.
You just resist a little bit and create this kind of isometric tension by I try to rotate in my hand resisting, and like this for 30 seconds. And slowly I will turn to the opposite way. I will hold like this with both hands. Inhale, and slowly, this absolutely passive movement. You see, you can even jaw a little bit, like this, and again. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and exhale. Yeah. Now, lateral, we will push lateral, we will push like this against hand, and we will create, and again, this is neutral position, 30 degrees, you put and you start pushing and hold on, and you remember what happened at the time of isometric exercise, isometric tension, all these muscles, they tried, first attempt to constrict, movement resisted, and this, they kind of stretch all muscles. All fibers right now participates.
all fibers, if there is any initiation of the pathological disbalance of adequate energy production, of constriction, so already you avoided this. Yeah? And you like this, you play sync, you flex maximum, inhale, and exhale. Like this. Hands, and you're creating isometric tension by pushing back against wall, and to create this isometric tension. And to hold, you see, I'm just pressing against wall. And to hold like this for 30 seconds. It's kind of pressure against wall have to be kind of significant. And after this, inhale, and with exhale, you're just moving you forward. And now the other post-isometric relaxation on the shoulder, you're doing like this. You're just placing like this, and you're pushing with this movement. You're just creating isometric tension. Hold for 30 seconds. And after this, slowly you're moving against wall. Right now, post-isometric relaxation we will do on flexors. You maximum, you extend like these hands after the 30 degrees. This is approximate 30 degrees. You place your other hand to resist, and you create gradually. You push this direction. You push against. It don't have to be kind of a significant pressure. You push against other hands. You're creating in these flexors isometric tension. And after 30 seconds with inhale, exhale, and you're stretching them. Inhale and exhale. In cases of tennis elbow, it's very important. All you know, region of elbow, I mean, all injuries of elbow region, wrist, it is important to do this exercise. Now, the same we will do, we will start rotating, we resisting this movement for 30 seconds, and inhale and exhale. Right now, we kind of mobilize with post-isometric relaxation, which include neuromuscular reeducation, you understand, but most important, the balance, the muscles, and especially paravertebral muscles. Now we did this with cervical spine, thoracic, and right now the erectors of lumbar spine. Just like this, we're holding and resisting, and you see this movement, what I'm doing, I'm creating, I hope camera will sure, I just pushing against this bed sheet, I'm pushing and I create isometric tension in paravertebral muscles. Yeah, after 30 seconds, I just hold like this, inhale and exhale. Absolutely passive stretching. Now the straight leg, you hold like this and you're creating this isometric tension, and 30 seconds approximately. We're starting here approximately, I raise like 35, 40 degrees. After 30 seconds, you relax, inhale and exhale. If this is my flexion, I will go like 30 degree from flexion, and I will have this attempt and will hold. You see, right now, muscles that are responsible for this attempt, they contort, and I hold them 30 seconds, like this. And after, and again, using the opportunity, I would like to refer you, have to theoretical part, you have to learn well, you have to understand what you're doing. Now, at the time of isometric tension, what happened, and post-isometric relaxation, inhale,
take more than only cerebral muscle activation. Hold for 30 seconds, slowly. It's little by little, just try 10, and you will feel for this kind of movement, for this movement, it's you just rotating your body, you hold, and after this, inhale and exhale. And your hair on this stretch, you can help with when you move like this, try to support with legs. When you move to this stretching, you can help a little bit with this arm. And with this, and again.
Rehabilitative exercise for lower back and thoracic region shouldn't be started until pain sensation will be reduced significantly. Movement have to be approximately free of pain. And therefore, before we will start the rehab exercise, it's important to provide 5, 6 to 10 massage therapies with combination of ice massage, and we will bring the situation and pain sensation on level 2 on scales from 0 to 10. Otherwise, it's not really a good idea to start through pain forcing the movement. With post-isometric relaxation, it's less movement, and of course there's a necessary effort that not causing the pain. Usually post-isometric relaxation almost no pain sensation causing. And we know in pain and very intensive pain, muscles reacting by constriction. Therefore, not to force movement, any movement have to be stopped, and this is what your clients have to be explained the moment when he does in some direction movement and he feel pain and the kind of increasing intensity of pain, he have to move to different direction. This is the initial position. You see the arms and thighs create like approximately 90 degree with the floor or table, and we call this a cat exercise. Slowly we will extend and head go down. You see, and very good if we will just for re-educate. Full extension, yes, like this. And again, 5, 10 times takes. And in this case, in order to be in balance, and you can see he stay in balance, the all these muscles include quadratus lumbarum right now have to be activated to keep, and this kind of static exercise contributes significantly to strain the muscles. And opposite, in this case, will be left arm slowly. And of course, we will position this exercise. Could be performed on floors and must be on table, on floor. And the first 5, 6 session, it's good if we will stay and we will control the movement. Repeatedly, we'll repeat the stretch. And again, the maximum stretch also have to be demanded from your sides until point that creating pain. If there is some pain, just a little bit reduce. You see the angle of stretching, and we're not forcing the pain. After being like this 5-10 seconds, we will ask our clients to move to extension. To extension, arms could be removed a little bit, hands forward, and to go to extension, kind of cobra exercise. Cobra head up, 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 like this, little by little.